and welcome. Thanks for joining us. Two of the best teams in the game square off. It's Palm Beach taking on the Houston Astros. John Ciambi, Chris Singleton with you. On both sides, this game really matters as the postseason is approaching.
Well, at this point of the year, guys are a little bit tired, but you've got to find a way to dig deeper and bring out your best with so much opportunity to be able to punch your ticket for October.
Just about set to go now. And today's starter, Framber Valdez. He's a guy that gets better when things get tough.
Well, it hasn't been a great year so far in terms of ERA.
So now the Astros designated hitter, Jose Altuve, singing. He's a guy that covers both sides of the plate about as well as anyone in the sport. How difficult is that to do?
Well, just look at the back of my bubblegum card. You'll see how hard it is. These guys are great, man. They have the ability to look out there, but also to be able to turn on the inside pitch. Those that can really sharpen things on the outer half, those are the ones that become elite.
Got it. Looking, that's a strikeout.
Frustrating end to the at bat for the hitter, and I'm sure that's going to sit on him for a little while. You want to be ready to hit the fastball. Sometimes you can overthink things, and I think that was the case right there.
Fires across the diamond, and here this afternoon, two quickly away in the bottom of the first.
Yeah, I'm looking at his body language, and he just doesn't seem like things are in sync, and the ball's just not coming off his bat the way it did earlier in the regular season.
Two outs, bases empty. Stepping in, the long ball threat, Jeff Bagwell. Liner, base hit. And that keeps the inning going.
Didn't take long to get a result for that at bat. Just a very nice approach and swing right there to use the big part of the field. Everything was on time. He stayed balanced through the entire swing and just launched that one into center.
Here's Jordan Alvarez. And immediately pumps in a strike to the left-handed hitter. Two gone, but the go-ahead run is at first. You're in game one of this three-game set.
And a bat like this is almost over as it begins. In this situation, you have no idea what the next pitch is going to be.
Swing and a miss, struck him out. That's the third out, inning over. One left for Houston, scoreless after one. He said,
told you so. Three.
And welcome back to the ballpark. Here's Kyle Tucker.
The right fielder.
Tucker, who's been an all-star and a gold glover. As the lefty gets to work. Late swing, foul to the left. The 0-1. Popped up to the left into foul ground. And there's one down.
Batting six. The center fielder.
Chaz McCormick digs in now.
He's done a great job making contact recently. Currently owns a 7-game hitting streak.
There's a strike, 95 of that one. Santana, a multi-Cy Young Award winner. He features a four-seam fastball, a slider, a changeup, a sinker, and he occasionally uses a curve. And that quickly, two away.
Fell off to a great start. He's really cruising out there on the mound. He's got a chance to get through these first two innings with under 20 pitches. That could set him up to go deep into this game.
Jeremy Pena now at the plate as he swings through strike one.
Man, he really sells the changeup with that arm action.
Just missed.
Well, he's so great about hitting the ball the other way. He gets those arms extended. So right there, just trying to straighten him up a little bit so he doesn't have as much outside plate coverage.
Two down, nobody on. And strike two.
Two ball, two strikes.
Still 2-2 after the foul ball. The wind of the pitch. Out to short. Jeter throws to first, and the inning is over. Astros go down 1-2-3. We'll move to the third with no score. As we go to the last of the third. Now it's Alex Bregman.
The third baseman, Alex.
The wide to kick the pitch. Santana, 25 years old, and a two-time Cy Young Award winner. Kicks and fires. Swings and misses. And it's 0-2. These two offenses can put up runs in a hurry. That one misses. 1-2 to count.
Pretty standard high 0-2 fastball right there. If you're smart, you'll look for something down in the zone, but not too far. Don't want to chase that breaking ball in the dirt.
The 1-2. Out towards left center. Anderson moves under it. Makes the catch, and there's one gone.
Batting none. The catcher.
And next to hit for Houston, Yainer Diaz. He's someone that really beats up on right-handed pitching. The lefties, however, give him a little bit more trouble. That one's in there, and it's 0-1. Still tied at zero, last of the third. And a foul ball. The pitch. Stays alive. Good eye in that spot.
It's a good take.
One out, base is empty. For the strikeout. Fastball at the letters, frozen for strike three.
Now
so the Houston lineup turns over. Jose Altuve up to hit here.
Went down looking on three pitches last time. Let's see if he can be a little more aggressive right here.
He swings and fouls one off. That's down and in. Two out, space is empty. Swing and a ball lifted in the air, left field, pretty well struck. Henderson going back. Just missed it. On to the fourth, still scoreless. The number two hitter, Craig Biggio. And Craig and Kevin Biggio were just the second father-son combo to each hit for the cycle. Pretty cool for both of them. And you know how I love the cycle. The 1-0. And a good eye there.
Talking about Craig's son, Kevin, he's a solid player. Has a lot of his dad in him, too. Plays the game real hard.
The 2-0 is in for a strike.
2-0, one strike.
On the ground, Jeter to first. One out in the bottom of the fourth.
Well, he's doing a nice job of keeping the ball out of the air. Lets the defense work behind him with another ground ball. Good execution.
Bagwell at the plate now. That's ball one.
Definitely a swing and miss slider down and in. He finished that really well. Just couldn't get him to offer at it.
And that's a base hit. So they get a man aboard with a one-out single.
dominant performance for him today, Boo. Just two hits allowed so far, no runs across either, and he's had an answer for just about every hitter he's faced, so I don't think this hit is going to knock him off the stride too much.
One gone, runner at first. Now it's Yordan Alvarez. Cracks his bat and pops him up. Barehand grab to first. Nicely done for the out.
Well, that actually works out for the hitter. If it's not a broken bat, it's hit hard enough for a double play. But with the slower roller, defense does a nice job at least getting one out of it.
Now it's the right fielder, Kyle Tucker. First pitch just misses. Runner at second, two down. We're here in the bottom of the fourth. High fly ball, right field. This could go the distance. Home run! He hammers one out to right. It's 2-0. Cressy's homered in back-to-back games now.
Yep, seeing the ball well, and he's got his timing locked in. He's looking pretty dangerous at the dish right now.
There's a big grin on his face right now, Boo. He's probably had some of those that didn't stay fair, but off the bat, it looked like he was going to bend foul. Was able to keep it in there, tucked it nicely, and he gets the jog around the bases. Good for him.
Now, here is Chaz McCormick.
All one's the count.
Two down now. Two outs. Swinging a foul over the screen and back out of play. And delivers outside.
Recognize that changeup right out of the hand. Just spit on it.
Hits and misses. It's a strikeout. Two runs for him, and they jump it. Back here in Houston. Now it's the shortstop, Jeremy Pena.
The shortstop.
Santana back to work. Hit on the ground to the right side. He handles it himself. One up, one down.
Third baseman number two, Alex Bregman.
Here's Alex Bregman. Fly to left his first time. Close one, doesn't get the call. And that's ball one. And that one fouled off.
Pitch to him.
And here comes. And it's fouled away. Base is empty, one away. Last half of inning number five. Foul ball still, one and two count. Battling here as he fouls it away. The pitch. And nope. That's off
that's
the inside edge. And the count is 2-2. Goes down looking.
Oh, you know that's got to be very frustrating for this guy. He knows the strike zone extremely well. And you know what? Good hitters are not going to compromise. He'll take that punch out, but ultimately stick with his plan and have more success than anything else.
At the plate is the Astros catcher, Yainer Diaz. And there's the strike.
0-1.
Just missed. Two down, nobody on. Here in game one of this three-game set. Next offering in there for a strike. And that is strike two. Keeps the at-bat going with a foul ball. Line of the pitch.
That's outside.
Foul ball, another 2-2 upcoming. swing and a high fly ball to left. And Ricky Henderson the grab. And that is that. Back here in Houston. Well, we go bottom six. Now it's the DH, Jose Altuve.
Altuve.
Hard ground ball, base knock. Man aboard on the leadoff single.
Well, clearly he was ready to hit right there. Pretty tough for the infielders to do anything with that one. He pulled it hard into the outfield. Even when you keep it on the ground, it feels great when you hit a missile like that.
Biggio in the box now. Takes strike one. And that one fouled off.
With two strikes, may see some movement over there at first base, trying to stay out of the double play right here.
Next offering way off the plate. And that's a strikeout looking. Called strike three on a fastball up in the zone. And now the first baseman, Jeff Bagwell. Outfield playing very deep, not wanting anything over their heads. Just missed.
You can expect this hitter to be looking for something on a tee. He can get up in the air and untie this ball game.
Fought off foul. Trying to keep this a 2-2 game here in the bottom of the sixth. Next offering in there for a strike. One and two.
He's been great in this one. Eye-hand coordination just failed him a little bit right there.
Gets a piece there. We'll do it again. Here's a 1-2. Fouled off the plate. They'll do it again. The pitch.
That's Bolton.
Man at first, one away. Pitch got the better of him that time.
Oh, interesting. He's looking very comfortable out of the stretch after giving up the leadoff single. Back-to-back strikeouts. So they haven't been able to move that runner up, get him into scoring position, and try to have a better chance of scoring. I tell you, good job so far on the mound. He just needs one more out.
Out to short. Zips it to first. That ends the frame. So the Astros lead one, and this game is still tied at 2-2. Set for the last half of the seventh. And stepping in for the Astros, Kyle Tucker. As he turns on the rubber, with that good live arm delivers. Fastball in for a strike. It's 0-1. And he swings and lifts one to deep center field. Trout ranges back. Say goodbye to that one. Second home run of the game, and the Astros jump in front. It's 3-2.
You're not going to be able to wipe the smile off his face for a while, Boo. He just changed the game. Power versus power right there, like two locomotives colliding. Who's going to win? A really good job there by the hitter, getting the top hand working. Powers that fastball out of here.
So next up for Houston, Chaz McCormick. That misses the zone, and that's ball one.
Always exciting to see a leadoff home run in an inning. Kind of gets the offense fired up, and you start to expect a big inning.
Swing and a ball driven pretty well out towards left center. Makes the catch, and there's one away.
It's a good recovery, though, after giving up the home run. Not allowing it to stay in the head, but going to work at the next hitter. And a tough one at that.
Pena, batting with one down, takes a strike. One out, base is empty, and a run in near the bottom of the seventh. Next offering is in for a strike.
Well, he didn't like those first two pitches. Now in an 0-2 hole. He's going to have to battle. Hope he gets a mistake.
And 1-2.
Really good take, especially with two strikes.
That one to first. This looks like extra bases. Takes the turn. He's digging for second. Tag, and he's safe. It's a hustle double.
Love how he let that ball travel, trusted his hands. Nice job of going the other way.
Manager out of the dugout now, and it looks like we'll see a change on the mound. Johan Santana is done, and he kept him in it even though he's in line for the loss right now. New arm when we come back. They hand the ball over to a new arm, Tom Henke.
Just trying to keep this one close here, and this is where a bullpen can give their players a chance to fight back into the game. Series, and there's just such a good feeling when you're in your own ballpark, you're sleeping in your own bed, you're eating your clubhouse manager's food, everything's right in your world, and they played like it today.
And your final score, 5-2. For Chris Singleton and our entire outstanding crew here at MLB The Show, I'm John Schaumer. Thanks for joining us.
The Lakers head round here, and no, I'm not the heir apparent to whoever. They never could outwit us. Try to think fast, but never could outwit us. The only thing that they could ever do is outfit us. When clothes fit strange, I'm playing Rick James. You see us? Oh, come on. We make them want to say it again. Yeah, we make them want to say it again. Beats from Mr. Dalvin.
That's our final line score this afternoon. First for the victorious Astros.
Be okay.